Yeah, everyone could hear you guys.
Yeah.
No, only the main.
To the Armenian MC Cypher 2020. You know we had to bring it back. Armin, get him, bro.
Yeah. My people left forsaken. I came to bless the nation with Satan. I'm God's amazement of his own creation. Forever scarred, still we grind until this hunger starves us. We heartless with more heart than like 300 Spartans. This survivor's genetics, God is a witness. This shit David versus Goliath. We lions lead a giant beheaded. We like soldiers in the trenches here to defend. So we flood the streets like Azaris flood my DMs. So when a bunch of black G-Wagons pulling up, heat packing, these cats got the streets back and turning up. MCs lacking the talent and deep passion. They just keep yapping, oh yes, they indeed capping. Sure enough, ease back and just know we don't be slacking. Relax, it's sounding sharp as feedback with me rapping. Turn them up. 9.999% of these rappers.
Well, being a part of the Cypher, Armin hit me up and asked me to be the key element of like starting it off. And I was, well, of course, I was with it. Armin's my homie, he's my brother. So whatever he does, I support. And the Cypher gets a lot of Armenians together, a lot of talent together. You don't even have to be Armenian to be a part of it. But yeah, I think it's a good move. And I'm a part of it, man. I, you know, I'm all about anything that keeps my nationality and nationality.
What's good, y'all? It's your boy Frank O'Drew. I want to give a shout out to my boy Armin and Pentagon Records, the whole family that's with us right now too. This Armenian MC Cypher is a huge thing to me, man. I've been waiting for this shit since 2016 when they did the last one. 4 years later, 2020, the big number, we did it, man. A lot of shit's going down in our country right now between Armenia and Azerbaijan, as many of you might know. But we're trying to put on for our people right now, man, and we gotta do what we gotta do. Stay blessed, y'all.
Houses, I'm from the block. Posted outside Little Caesars, I roam the streets like Julius Caesar in Rome. I'm a king, wear a crown of thorns made of barbed wire. Those who cross me get caught in the crossfire. Son of God, member of the lost tribe. Live my whole life on the dark side. I hopped out of Noah's Ark, I'm out.
What it means to be an Armenian MC Cypher, because I'll put on for my people regardless. But this year, out of all years, it means more because of the simple fact of what's going on. So I feel even more proud being here with my brothers and representing. I'm more than proud to be here with my brothers. I'll always be here with my brothers, whether it's with my brothers or brothers from another tribe, as long as they're fighting for survival and for the truth and to be good human beings, I'll be there. Who am I? My name is 1-2. Remember that shit.
So for me, honestly, I was really honored when Armin asked me to be a part of the Armenian Cypher, just because I started rapping not about a year ago. And I mean, everything I do, I take really, really seriously. And it's something that my mom was an opera singer, and I've just always practiced. I've always had like singing lessons since I was a kid, because I was in theater school. And it just so happens I released a song a year ago and it did really well. And Armin heard me rap one day and was just like, "You're actually really good," which is a very huge compliment, you know? And then obviously what's happening in Armenia right now is just disgraceful, and it's so heartbreaking, and it hit my home personally, to be honest. I was personally affected by it. My 19-year-old cousin was skinned and dismembered. And honestly, all I wanted to do was just a prayer, the Armenian prayer for everyone. And then, you know, I had to hit him with a couple bars just to let him know one time that I could.
What it means to me to be an Armenian Cypher, it means the world to me, because
You know, I grew up listening and looking up to Armin, and it's just so crazy to be rapping alongside him. So it means everything to me.
It's a beautiful thing. What I do like is it gives opportunity to up-and-coming guys that might not be known, you know what I mean? And it gives them a platform, and it gives them a little trampoline, a push, you know? So the best thing about it is the solidarity, you know? And especially this year with everything going on with Artsakh, you know, it's something that the community needed to do. You know, if we never did one this year, we should have done one just to show the unity.
What's going on, everybody? My name is Sarkis, and I go by the Foreign Shooter, and I had the opportunity to direct Armin and MC Cypher 2020. I've known Armin and the Pentagon family for over 10 years now. We worked on numerous projects together. Throughout the production process, we faced numerous challenges, but none of which were more difficult than this particular scene right here. The shot was sent to us by Nautic Mets directly from Armenia, who ended up going to the front lines to fight a war 2 days later. There was no way for us to communicate with him, no way for us to ask for any additional footage. What we got is what we had to work with. To give you guys an idea, in order to export Nautic from the background, since there was two AK-47s in the back, we couldn't use the shot. And in order for us to actually remove Nautic from the background, we needed to go through 1,500 frames one by one and mask the layer out entirely. So to put things into perspective, like I mentioned, there was over 1,500 frames we needed to go through to edit. For you guys to understand what that means, this particular shot had 25 frames in 1 second of footage. So you do the math. So for us to actually get through the entire thing, again, 1,500 plus frames had to get edited. We got the job done, and I hope you guys enjoyed the final result.
Yo, extra special shout out to my man, Ill Kid. He was supposed to fly out for the shoot. He's like, yo, I'm at the airport, they're not letting me fly out. Apparently, Canada is still mad strict on the COVID rules. Long story short, he didn't make it. But you know what? We got you next time, bro. Shout out to my man, Ill Kid. He killed his verse. Maybe y'all hear it one day. Peace.